Hi friends, welcome to my next video, how to publish a paper in international journals. Come, let's go to the video. The writing of an accurate, understandable paper is just as important as the research itself, says Robert A. Day. This is very important. If you know you have to know the mechanics of writing, that is as equal as doing the research. And this presentation is to help you to make your paper writing effective and to get it published. You will learn the following from this video. First one, you will know how the things to do before you begin your writing process: planning your paper, choosing a journal to publish, things after choosing a journal, learning from a model paper, writing up different sections of your paper, things to do while writing, and final checklist. Come, we'll see one by one. Before I proceed to my video, you may wonder, how am I eligible to teach you these things? Because I'm a professor and with 17 years experience in teaching and research. Actually, I did my PhD, I completed a long back, and I did my PhD in 3 years, and the other remaining thing is as a reviewer of various journals, and I have been serving as a reviewer for almost last 10 years. Examining PhD thesis of various universities. I have served as external examiner, and I have published so far 38 journal papers, including 15 Scopus Index journal, and I have delivered keynote addresses in international conferences at Singapore, Malaysia and Thailand. I have presented paper at IATFL UK and TESOL USA conferences. Both are highest repute conferences in my field, that is English language teaching, and I am a PhD research guide as well. Already my first candidate completed her PhD, and remaining 5 of them are working under my guidance for their degree. And to get more research related videos like this, please subscribe my YouTube channel and click the bell icon to get immediate notification when I post my next video. If you like this video, I'll be happy to hear your comments at the end of this video. If you find it useful, please share this to your friends. Okay, the first thing. Before you begin the writing process, what are you supposed to do? There are 5 components you have to be really clear about before you start your writing process. First one, you need to have a clear understanding about what journals are looking for. That is, in terms of theme as well as in English, you have to be clear. Second thing, you have to know about standard phrases used in English. That is, how you have to write. You need to have a collection of standard phrases in research writing. Then how a typical paper is structured in your field, because paper structure may vary field to field. Theoretically, in literature it may vary somewhere. Literature paper is different from the ELT paper. Experimental paper is different from analytical paper. So you have to know according to your own field, know the structure of your paper. And what makes your research unique? That's what, before you start writing, you need to know that you have certain unique thing to inform, otherwise there is no point in writing a paper. And what referee's expectation may be. So when you want to publish a paper, your paper will be reviewed by the referees, that is the reviewers, and you have to understand their requirement and their expectation accordingly. You have to work, so you have to be ready about all these things, then only you should start writing the you should begin your paper. Second thing, how are you supposed to plan your paper? First, you have to think about why you want to publish your research. What is the reason? Do you have anything really interesting to say to the other people? And really, is it innovative and creative and something valuable thing you can inform? Then you have to know clear objective of your publishing the thing. Give yourself enough time to plan and write your manuscript. Manuscript is nothing but a paper, the paper, when you prepare the paper before the submission, it is called manuscript. And choose an appropriate journal, preferably with a high impact factor. Before you publish, you must know which journal you are going to publish. For that, you have to choose an appropriate journal with high impact factor. Even though you are a beginner, you are a fresh researcher, nothing wrong in choosing the high impact factor, because that will, once you set up a high standard, that will help you to scale up your research in a very, very, very great high, so that in the future you will become a great personality in your field. And you may wonder, what is an impact factor? Impact factor is a measure of how a prestigious a journalist. If it has a more impact factor, the journal is really good. If it is a less impact factor, the journal is not as good as the high impact factor journal. And how to choose a journal? Now we have identified the broad thing, you know, about journal. Then how to choose exact journal to publish? There are, first thing, before you decide, probably you must consult with your professor, that is your guide, or a colleagues, about the most appropriate journal where you can publish your research paper, because you may not have a right idea. So they will be able to guide you in a proper direction. So always you can consult with your guide as well as your other colleagues to which journal to publish. Second thing, an impact factor, as already told you in the previous slide, an impact factor is a measure of how a prestigious a journal is. Certain journal will have more than 5 impact factor, 8 and all, because that is, has a great kind of quality. And it is really very difficult to publish in a high impact factor journal, but still you always aim high, one day you will be able to do that. And after that, after looking at the impact factor and other thing, you can possibly select 3 to 4 journals in your field. Because one, you cannot narrow down immediately one journal. Probably you try to choose 3 to 4 possible journals. Look at their styles. Reading through their papers, you can look at their style and think about their audience. That is, who are the real audience to read the paper. What do the editors and the readers expect from that article? Because once you read the article from a particular journal, and when you read a wide range of article, you will understand what do they normally expect from that particular paper. Then after this 3-4, narrowing down the 3 to 4 journal, then you select and choose an appropriate journal, preferably with a high impact factor, and then you can start working on. The high impact factor, the advantage of publishing in a high impact factor is you will get more readers, more people will cite your research will become more visible to other person. Once you publish in a high impact factor journal, obviously when you say that you have got a publication in that particular journal, your academic repute is very high. That's why I am asking you to publish in a high reputed journal. Then you have chosen a journal. Now what will you do after that? After choosing the journal, the first thing you have to do, download the guidelines for authors. If you go to the journal homepage, definitely you will find the author instruction, author guidelines, some kind of way they could have mentioned you. Download their author guidelines. That is the main, I would say that's a Bible for you to learn about what journal is really expecting from your paper. So you understand clearly, spend a lot of time to read and understand their instruction, then you start it. Then, after reading their instruction, then you in that particular journal choose a frequently cited paper in the particular journal. That is, if you go to the if you check the citation of that particular journal, that in the list you can understand which journal has more citation, which particular paper has more citation. You download that paper. It means that once the particular paper is cited frequently, it means that it is a very good research. So it will help you to understand how they have constructed their argument in their paper. You will get an idea about how to construct your own paper through, to taking the model from the paper. After taking the model, then you have to read and analyze papers for your literature review and note how they have structured their paper. That's very, very important. And at the end, obviously you have to understand the exact requirement of the editor, then because they may not directly tell you, but once you read the author's guideline, you may understand. And once you read the other papers from this particular journal, you may understand what kind of papers normally they accept, what kind of people are normally accepted to publish. You will understand clearly, then you can go further. Next thing, what are the expectation of a journal from a paper? Come, let's see. First thing, they'll check whether your paper is contributing to the existing knowledge. Second thing, whether you have organized and readable your paper. Then the soundness of methodology, that whether your methodology of your paper is really good, and whether you have proper evidence to support your conclusion, and whether you have adequacy of literature review here, whether you have done an exhaustive literature review, they'll check. These are the what you call exhaustive expectation of the journal from any paper. Come, let's see how will they normally review the paper? First thing, once they review the paper, they'll give you the strength, weakness and suggestion to the author. And in this the component, if your paper is really good, they'll mention about the strength and weakness, strength, and if there are some weakness, they'll mention. So the reviewer, they will review the paper and they submit a report based on these parameter to the journal editor. Then he will decide to whether accept and reject the paper. And normally reviewer's decision, reviewer the previous thing along with the strength and weakness and the other thing, they'll submit this kind of a reviewer report, and the 5-point scale report generally the journal may follow. And one is declining the submission, 5 is the accepting the submission, because once if your paper is rated as a 5, it is excellent, without any modification the paper is accepted for the publication. Fourth category, the paper is good, there may be a minor revision, that is, there are one or two things you have to add in the your paper, and that's what the fourth one. Third category of the paper, it is acceptable, the journal provisionally they'll accept your paper, but you must revise whatever the suggestion given by the reviewer. Whereas in the fourth one, that's a minor revision, but here the revision may be more. And second one, you have to resubmit for review, major revision required, means here most of the paper you have to redo, and it is almost near to the rejection, but still they have some hope on your paper, so you have to entirely rework and you have to resubmit the paper. And declining means once your paper is completely not suitable to that particular journal, or idea is not clear, no way it is related, then they may reject your paper. And what do you need to learn from a model paper? As I already mentioned to you that you have to download a model paper. What are the things you have to learn from a model paper? First one, as I already told you that you have chosen a one model paper. You have to map your research imitating the style and organization. From that model paper, you try to map your own style of writing. That may help you to map your research, because you may not, now as a researcher, you may not know how to write. That particular model paper may help you as a what you call model to design your own research paper. Second thing, note down useful standard phrases from your model paper, which you may possibly use it in your paper. But you cannot take the idea, but I am talking about only grammatical structure of the sentences or probably a phrases you can take, and you can redo it. And always you have to make sure that if you have taken anything from any paper, you must cite them, because otherwise you cannot quote anything without giving a due citation. And last one, you have to know about how they have structured your paper. What are the component, look at the, and under that component you have to check the 5 things. One is, how does the author begin his paper? What points does he make in each section? How does he or she links paragraph together? How does he connect the results with the discussion? How does he present the conclusion? So you have to clearly understand these flow, then only you will be able to, because this is going to be a guideline for your own paper, so you have to get a detail about all these things clearly. Next thing, what order do you need to write different sections of your paper? And there are, different sections of the paper, right from abstract to the till the references, but what are the way you have to write? That's what. First, you should start with abstract, but that's not a original abstract, it's a rough draft of the abstract before you start writing. Then don't write, because here the order is entirely different. Look at the order clearly. You are not writing introduction first, you are writing first rough abstract, rough draft of the abstract, then you are writing a method, because that's what your own contribution. So you have to clearly mention about the method, then you have to write about the results, then you have to write about the discussion, then only you have to write the introduction, because introduction should be written at the end, before either after the conclusion or before the conclusion. So after writing introduction, if you write the conclusion, because there should be a proper connection between introduction and conclusion, that's why introduction and conclusion should be written together at the end, after writing this method, results and discussion. At the end only you have to write the abstract, that's very the final version of the abstract. I'll let you know how you are supposed to write the abstract. What are the things you need to include in the different sections of the paper? First one, in the abstract, it's the heart of the paper. I'm not talking about what you need to include in the abstract, that is a separate slide is coming, just wait, you look at the other section. Introduction, you have to give a broad outline about your research area. And in the review of the literature, you have to review the related works on your particular area. Then research questions have to be clear and precise. Don't write ambiguous research question. That's a basic flaw. If your research question is not clear, definitely they will not accept your paper. Then in method section, you have to mention about the sample, instrumentation. Here instrument means what are the treatment you have used, instrument, different instrument questionnaire, and what are the research tool you have used, you have to mention. How you have used that research tool for the intervention, other thing you have to mention clearly. Then you have to mention about the procedures for the data collections clearly in this under the method section. Then procedure for the data analysis also you have to mention in the method section. And these things are very important in the method section. Next, the findings, you have to clearly mention about your clear findings. The discussion section, you have to mention summary of the findings, because you may have so many findings, so you have to summarize clearly. So this is a very important part of your paper, because this is what final outcome of your paper. So do it very well, give most important to this. And limitations, here you have to mention one separate section called limitations. That is limitation of your paper, because this is a crucial section. You have to go out of your way to list all weakness of your study. It steals the thunder of your reviewers, because once you are ready to accept your weakness of the paper, then the reviewer will be very happy to note that you have clearly mentioned your limitation of the study. And interpretations, be sure to take the time to do this well. Your readers want to know how you interpret and what you have found in your study. These are the things should be given in the discussion. Next, you have to mention about this. The other section is suggestions for the further research based on what you did. What should now be done? Do a good job here. Go to the limitation section. Accordingly, you can mention about suggestion for future research. And pedagogical implication, you can mention about the implication from your research for the pedagogical, to the field, teaching field, or the whoever it the field is respected to that. You must mention the implication of your study. Finally, you have to give the conclusion here. What you finally derive conclusion from your own finding, you have to mention here. And references, you have to, very important, you have to have up to date references, and they'll check whether you have quoted the recent references. You are submitting a paper in 2020, definitely they'll check whether you have referred recent references. You have references only up to 2015, you don't have anything after 2015, means it's not good and they may not accept. So because you need to have a current after 2015, there may be a lot of papers could have published in your area. If you have not referred any paper in that, mean that it is not updated research paper. So you have to be very careful. You have to refer the paper up to date. And appendix, if you have used any questionnaire or sample thing, if you want to include in the appendix, you can include. Otherwise, no need to worry. And now you have to let us know about the clearly about what other things should be included in the abstract. See, the why the abstract is important. Whenever you send your paper to any journal, the first thing they'll read your abstract only. So you have to be very clear about, clear in a concise way. You have to give your abstract. Once your abstract is not impressive, definitely they'll not go further to your paper. And anybody, reviewer, editor, everybody rely heavily on your abstract first. Then they'll check whether you have to mention your topic clearly within the abstract. All these information, I'm going to give so many information now. All these things should be included in the abstract. Whether is the topic clearly stated? Is the aim of the study clearly stated? They'll check. The reviewer and editor, they'll check all these things. Is the sample size clearly mentioned in your abstract? Do you have clearly mentioned about the procedures of the data collection of the study? And have you mentioned about the data analysis? How you have performed the data analysis, have you mentioned clearly? And have you mentioned about any kind of, in the abstract itself, you have to mention about your finding, not entire finding. Probably a kind of one or two important findings you can mention in the abstract at the end. And the conclusions also you have to, based on your research, you have to mention within the abstract. So it's very important. Once again, let me go through. So this is very important. Abstract, always spend more time to write your abstract, because that is the heart of your paper, and you should not shabbily write your abstract. You have to write in a very clear way. So keep all these things in your mind very clear. And after completion of this thing, when you the writing exactly, now you have you have understood what are the things should be included in each section, and you have got a fair idea, and you have a model paper, you have mapped your paper with imitated, you have noted down the things, and everything is ready. Now you are starting the writing phase exactly now. So how can you write? Can you complete your paper within a day, within a week, within a month? No, it will take lot of time. Minimum, I would advise initial novice researcher should spend 3 to 6 months to complete one paper, so that he will learn really very well. So write day by day. Every day you write, inch by inch. That's what you have to go inch by inch, and you have to write every day. And consider having a separate document for each section. That's there are different sections: abstract, introduction, methodology, and finding. And all these sections are there. So when you start writing a paper, have a separate folder section for all these things. So whenever you have a certain idea about particular section, you can write, and parallelly, simultaneously, you can write on certain thing, because you will not be able to write everything on the same day on one particular section. So it is better you have a simultaneous all the sections material in a different folder. So in case if you are unable to complete it, what you call methodology section, literature review one particular day, you can work on the experimental setup, or you can work on the questionnaire, or in that way you can work. So you have a separate section for separate folders in your computer to work simultaneously on different section. Then you should write your paper in a way that even a non-expert in your field can understand your paper. So it has to be in a simple, lucid style. And access referees report forms to understand the way the referees will evaluate your work, because certain journal, they'll publish under what parameter they'll evaluate your work, and you can download their evaluation rubrics from their website. You download accordingly, you can prepare the paper also. Certain journal they may not openly say, but you can understand by reading the author guideline. And certain journal they will clearly give the evaluation rubric, certain journal they may not give, but if they are giving, it's well and good. You read take that and you read the evaluation matrix. Otherwise, in the when you read the author guidelines, that in that section, if you read it clearly, you will be able to grasp what exactly they expect from you. And last important before the last one, you must always strive to improve your writing skill, that is writing style. A style of writing have to improve day by day, because as I already mentioned, if you write day by day, and obviously definitely you can improve it when you finally prepare your particular first draft. And you can, whenever required, you use online resources, but make sure that if it is the important thing, you quote them. And before the final thing, during the writing phase, lot of the researchers, they'll face one important problem: procrastination. They keep procrastinating the work. Okay, let me do it tomorrow, day after tomorrow. Please do not procrastinate. That's what I already told you. Every day you have to make sure that you are moving an inch at least on your research. So you have a research, what you call a time schedule. Based on the time schedule you work on, make sure that every day you are moving at least an inch towards your research, so that after certain deadline, definitely after certain time, you will be able to complete your research. So don't procrastinate. And once you keep in engaging yourself in writing every day, definitely you will not get into procrastination. You will be able to complete. That's it. And before, after writing the paper, then finally you have to use these checklist to verify your paper before submit the journal. There is a two checklist. One is always have the referees in your mind. Check your paper whether it is according to the referees requirement. And even don't correct the paper with the laptop itself. Probably you take the printout of your paper, just take a hard copy, read again once again, then correct it. Check your paper for the readability. All the things you have done, as I already told you in the beginning of the presentation, whether you are able to read your paper clearly, readability. Then check for the clarity in the logical order of your argumentation, whether you have argued your paper in a properly, because if there is no logical connection, then they may not accept the paper. Even maybe a good paper, but only because of the illogical argument, they may not accept your paper. And do a quality control of your paper, that check whether really it is worth publishing, and whether really it is good, whether it has innovation, whether it has an idea to publish. You have to check that whether you have a core value for your paper. Last one in the checklist one, be careful whenever you cut, copy, paste. That's what normally people forget a lot of stuff. So whenever you take, as I already told you that, because if you use some material from other source and without, if you do not acknowledge them, it is a plagiarism. And a very important thing, all the journal nowadays, quality journal, they'll ask you to submit a plagiarism report also. Nowadays, the accepted plagiarism report is less than 10%. So you have to be careful about, everything is your own, you cannot plagiarize from any source. Checklist 2, after that you check, double check that you have followed the journal style guide, because even your work is valid, your writing is wonderful, everything is perfect, but you have not followed the journal style, because every journal, they follow their own style of paper writing. So you have to access through the author guideline, you could have accessed that thing. So you have to prepare a paper according to the journal guideline. Don't prepare paper then look for the journal, then you have to entirely redo the paper. So first understand, that's what I have told you already, choose appropriate journal, know their requirement, prepare accordingly. But don't prepare everything on your own style, then you have to entirely rework, that is a very difficult task. And don't forget forget the acknowledgement. If you have got some help, funding or anything else, you mention that in the acknowledgement section. You thank them for their help and other thing. And always after this, when you submit a paper through mail, always write a good email accompanying with your manuscript. Don't just like that, I am sending this paper, accepted. Don't like a one liner and all. Write a proper official formal email stating that why they need to accept your paper and mention it clearly, then submit. Then always make sure that you have to check, spell check. Lot of people, you rely for the spell check, automatic spell checker. Please do not rely on the automatic spell checker, because it may give a wrong thing. It may not understand the difference between American English and British English. So always spell checking, you have to be very clear, because these are the careless mistake. Because of this, you may lose a chance, and they may give you for the review again. You have to do certain review, because if it comes for the revision, it takes a lot of time. No, you are unnecessarily delaying your publication time. So don't do that. So do be careful about your spell check. And finally, before you submit, better you get a colleague or your friend to read your paper, how it is based on all the other parameters, whether it is really good to send. You get their opinion. At the end, finally, you are ready to submit. Submit with the hope that it will be accepted. Don't think that it will not be accepted, because a positive hope is very important. And if you do that, definitely, if you have followed all the parameters what I have given in this particular presentation, and 90% the journal will accept your paper, definitely. I guess this presentation is really useful to you, and I have taken sources for this presentation from this book.